This is a video that I took on the 22nd of March 2019. This was a party of people that I was taking to Longleat for a day out, and they had a very nice time there, and so did I actually. I'm very sorry there is no audio from the camera on this entire video. I forgot to actually enable the microphone, but you wouldn't have heard very much anyway, as it's at right at the back of the vehicle on the rear window. So I'll just do a little bit of narration every now and again to keep you up to speed with roughly where we are at any given time, and any other points of interest that there may be. You're just coming up to the crossroads now at East Stour, which is not too far from home for all of us, on our way towards Longleat, which is in Wiltshire. Actually, it's in the county of Somerset. I must get that right or people will complain. Yes, it's in the county of Somerset, not too far away from the town of Frome. Just heading out through East Stour at the moment, 30 mile an hour speed limit throughout the village. That white building you can see dissolving away into the background used to be a pub, believe it or not. A rather a strange place to sight a pub, I would have thought, but yes, it used to be a pub. Not so many of them about nowadays, with the fact that people just don't go out and don't have the ready cash as they used to. Times are hard for everybody, so it's cheaper to go to the supermarket and buy the drinks in and sit at home. And I suppose a lot of people sit and watch the television, no doubt sports and other items like that, and drink at home. Not being into alcohol, I'm not bothered if there were no pubs, to be truthful, but I do understand that people do like to go and have a drink. Here's a pub here, just gone past actually. They've got a car park on the other side of the road on that bend, which is a really weird place to put a car park. I suppose it's the only place they could put it, but really dodgy. Because people do come around that corner sharply, and if somebody's on their way across, especially if they're not too fleet on their feet, or maybe they've had one too many, it could be a rather hazardous thing to do, to cross the road there. But there you are. People like to go and visit that pub. It seems to be quite popular. Just heading... We're out of East Stour now, heading downhill towards Magiston. There's a couple of really nasty bends as we go through Magiston. I always slow down to about 10 miles an hour, 15 miles an hour. That's as fast as I'd want to go around the bends. If you're in a car, it's not quite so bad because cars are lower to the ground and therefore not so prone to tip over. The vehicle I'm driving is quite high, comparatively speaking. It's quite a tall vehicle, and you certainly do notice bends and corners, especially sharp ones. It doesn't pay to travel around any corners very fast in this vehicle, not that you should be anyway. The comfort of the passenger should be the main thing. Their safety obviously is the main thing, but the comfort comes a very close second. Nobody likes to be shoved from side to side. This is the first bend. It looks nothing on the camera, but it really is very, very sharp. And so is the next one, which will be a left-hand bend. And then there's a couple more about a few hundred yards up the road further on. This is Magiston, incidentally, we're travelling through now. just coming up to the second series of bends. This one's quite sharp and it does catch a lot of people out. I've seen many a car through the hedgerow in the field and the fields opposite. Not a nice road to be a pedestrian either. Very dangerous to walk along this road as a pedestrian. But hey, if you've got to walk along it, you've got to walk along it. But I prefer to cross over as to the bends, which way the bends are going, so at least you can be seen by the traffic behind you, coming up behind you. It doesn't matter which side of the road you're on, as long as you can be seen. We're just coming in now to Gillingham. We've just crossed over the 30 mile an hour limit. We've got the factories and industrial units on the right-hand side as the view goes, private housing on the left-hand side. This is another awkward place to get through. You've got these vehicles usually parked here all the time. I don't suppose they've got a lot of choice, because behind those houses there's a railway line and an embankment, so there's no way they can park behind. But it's very awkward coming round that corner, especially when there's a lot of traffic about, especially oncoming traffic, big traffic, because you get Arctics and all kinds of large transport using this road. Just about to turn left at the lights here. Gillingham's quite a fast growing town. That white house you see, that's currently got scaffolding right round it. They're doing quite a major job of renovation to it. I don't know exactly what they're doing, but it's causing quite a few problems because they've got a set of temporary lights in, and the temporary lights never work correctly, so you've got really long delays. That is accurate as of the last time I went that way, which was last week. So we're on the, what date are we on now? We're on the 16th today. The 16th of the 10th, I might add. You've got all the stores. It's quite a well-appointed town, Gillingham, as far as shopping goes. They've got Aldi's, Lidl's, Asda, Waitrose for the more upmarket shoppers. There's lots of shops, lots of businesses. There's a big farm shop, which we passed as we came through that last set of lights, Mole Valley. So there's all sorts of businesses. So it's quite, as I say, it's quite well off for commerce in this town. Just come up to another set of lights, which I've managed to catch on red, as I usually do when I come along this particular road. A left turn would take you eventually towards Wincanton, which is in Somerset. And we're heading out now for Mere, which will be our next kind of major conurbation, Mere, which is in Wiltshire. So we've actually travelled through three counties, or we will travel through three counties on this journey. Gillingham is constantly expanding. I don't know exactly when the expansion is going to stop, but they seem to be always building new houses, new industrial units. I don't know where they think the economy is going to be coming from, because the way the world is at the moment, I can't see there being much of a recovery. America's in a really bad shape financially. So many people are out of work that probably would never be able to work again because of the way things are. And this country, I don't think, is a lot better. it's basically all service industry jobs, low paid, long hours, very unsocial jobs, but there doesn't seem to be the employment round anymore. So I don't know why they just don't stop this expansion, this constant expansion. It doesn't seem to make much sense, but then again, the whole world doesn't make much sense right now, especially with this idiotic COVIDiocy that has been foisted on us. It's patently a total lie and a fraud and a scam, but people still will not see it. They still believe it's a reality. Frightened of absolutely nothing at all. People are so weird. That's why I put the annotation up near the front of this video, referring to this trip was taken when people were relatively normal, well, just everyday people. Now they've turned into complete zombies. They are, I really don't know how to describe them. They seem to have lost all reason. That they're triggered by the slightest little aspersion. Anything that doesn't fit in with the paradigm they think they should be following, they are rabidly antagonistic towards. I find it very wearing, and quite frankly, it's quite disgusting. I don't know how people can't see this is a total sham and a lie, this whole thing. But you can't teach pork, as they say. There's no cure for stupid. And unfortunately, most of the population in this country at the moment seems to be in the category of stupid. As you can see, it's a very nice day. We've got a bit of blue sky. There's some cloud about, but that actually disappears later on. It was a very, very warm day. In fact, it was unpleasantly warm for part of the day. But it was nice. My passengers enjoyed their day at Longleat. This video will take us right into the grounds of Longleat, or at least the driveway of Longleat. And after which I had other footage of walking around and when I parked the bus up, lots of other video, but because it was handheld and it's a bit jittery, I didn't include it. So I've just done the basic journey from and to, basically. There's no return journey, so it's just a single journey too. But you'll be able to see the countryside. The beautiful trees are out now in leaf, fresh leaves. And it was such a nice experience to have, to be able to go out and enjoy people as they were. So you could see their faces, you could see people smile and enjoying themselves. Now it's like a bloody parade of zombies. Wherever you go, they're like the living dead. It's a scary scenario. And you've got these people that profess to be, what, the people with letters after their name that profess to know what's going on. They're just, like the Bible said, in believing themselves wise, they prove to be fools. Most are, because they toe the government's line. They believe whatever the media tells them, whatever garbage is handed down to them as the truth, they will pick it up and run with it. That is it. That is set in stone. That is the way things are. Of course, they're totally foolish. They can't see. They haven't got the eyes or the intelligence to see they've been conned. But anyway, I don't want to make this a political... It's a bit deeper than anything political. Although politics is very heavily involved in it, of course. I don't want to make this a diatribe about this ridiculous non-existent bug. Oh, incidentally, viruses can't live outside the body. In fact, they're not even classed as being alive anyway. They're they're not actually alive in the sense of the word. So they certainly cannot live outside the human body. They can't be transmitted via sneezes and coughs. So all this nonsense with this mask wearing, this muzzle wearing, is complete garbage. But like I often say, no mask here, not now, not ever. Just coming up to the T junction. We're in Mere now. Mere's a nice little town, actually. The town is actually the way the car's going. It's down the road to the right of the T junction we've just come out of. There are a few industries on the way out of the town. We're right on the edge of it, really. There's a place just across the road on the left-hand side, as you're looking at the screen, that makes candles. They've been there for a long time, but a very nice place. I've been in there and had a look round. Excuse the cough. It's not COVID, I can assure you. Just about to pass under the A303, which is the main trunk road from basically from Honiton right up to the M3 in Hampshire. So it's quite a long road. Just passed under it there, back there with the overbridge. Now it's all basically nice little country roads all the way up. You'll see some nice scenery on the way. It's rather a strange viewpoint, but I find it's very useful to have the two cameras, one facing and one trailing, because the reason I did buy dash cams was obviously the reason most people have a dash cam, especially with the standard of driving there seems to be on our roads. If anything should happen or the untoward should happen, excuse me, it's very handy to have a record of it for insurance purposes, or in worst case scenario, for witness material in the case of an accident. So that's basically the reason I have a forward and rear facing camera. There's a little turning up here on the right-hand side as you're, excuse me, as you're looking at the screen. It's a little place called Gasper. I thought that was a very peculiar name to give to a village. Well, it's not even a village. There's not enough houses there to call it a village. It's like a little, just like a little hamlet, I suppose. I don't think it would even be classed as a hamlet. There's just a few houses there, but they've given it a name and they call it Gasper, which is rather a funny name. I always think of them as being heavy smokers that live down there, but they probably aren't. I actually was so intrigued with that name. That's a turning for it there. I was so intrigued with that name, I actually took myself out of my way to go down there and have a look. There's also gardens, Stour Gardens, or I can't remember if that's a correct title, but it's very picturesque as you go down there. The road is quite narrow, and if you drive right on down there's plenty of little roads that lead to absolutely nowhere. But you go through the estate, it's very popular with tourists, even now. With this nonsense going on, there's a lot of people going there. There was the last time I went there a few weeks ago. There is also a turning as well, which we've past. Also on the right, which takes you to an old edifice, King Alfred's Tower, which is kind of a folly, as they would call them here. I think it's a folly. It looks like a kind of a castle or a tower, but it's not actually a castle. It's just a what they call a folly. It was just something built, but a lot of people go there. It's quite popular. They've got big car parks, free car parks, I hasten to add. So if you always wonder what that strange little thing was on the skyline in this area, from miles and miles away, you can see it from all over the place. If you've ever thought about going there, yes, it's quite interesting. Apparently, I've never been in there, been very close to it. But as I say, there are free car parks, so a good place to spend a few hours, and then go down to the Stour Estate Gardens. I think you've got to pay to get in there. I'm pretty sure you have, actually, but I'm not 100% sure on that. You can see the following traffic is keeping a reasonable distance behind me. The reason is they can't see through me. They cannot see through the windows because the vehicle is quite, the windows are quite high up, and also the rear ones have got a coating over them, vinyl coating, so you can't actually see through anyway. So unlike most vehicles, which you can see through their back screen, through their front screen, so you can see what's coming, you can't with this. It's just like following a wall of steel, so that they keep back so they can get some idea of the view around me. I think this actual car, he takes a bit of a chance, if I remember rightly. He took a bit of a chance. Yeah, he's going to overtake fairly soon. He got a bit fed up with following me. So he shot past me, but he overtook in rather a dangerous place, because as he overtakes and goes up a hill, there's a right-hand bend on the other side of the road towards him. And you cannot see in a car, you cannot see because there's a hedgerow both sides. And he actually overtakes this way. Here he comes now. Here he comes. There it goes. I remember somebody saying, oh, look at that idiot. Well, you will see there is a bend coming up. We're about to sweep round it now. You cannot see around there. He was very lucky because that lorry, had it been another second or two, that would have been a full head-on, and that would have been the end of that car driver and his passenger, or her passenger, whatever. And quite traumatic for the lorry driver, I would think, as well. Fortunately, it didn't pan out that way, but more by luck than judgment. Not a very long journey, this one. About, I was quite surprised when I had a look at the video files and found it was just over 20 minutes worth. I thought it was a lot longer than that, but apparently it isn't. This is real time. It's not sped up. It's certainly not slowed down. What you're seeing is actual footage taken on the day. Incidentally, anybody planning on going to Longleat this year, I don't know what kind of weird restrictions I'll have in place. There's sure to be some. It's quite a good place. There's plenty to see and do there. It's relatively inexpensive. Well, some people say it is expensive. I think all in all for value is not bad. It's not bad. I've been there once and I wouldn't want to go back again wandering around. I mean, I go there and drop people off and park up, but I wouldn't want to walk around again. They've got a bus, or a couple of double-decker buses there, which are quite decent. And they use those for the tourists to take them through the lion park. Obviously, the lions are out roaming free, and the people in the buses are the ones in the cage. And believe me, it's the safest place to be. They've got a tiger as well, or a couple of tigers they let run loose. So sometimes one of those big cats will get a thing in its head and chase the bus. It happened when I was there, actually. I was looking out the window. I was staring at this lion, and it suddenly got it into its head. It wanted to chase, so it chased the bus. Quite safe on there, but once they learn how to operate emergency door open buttons, then it'll be a different story. But until then, no, you're fairly safe on the bus. If it came to, all I would do is, if it got right up that close and it was a real threat, I would just run over it or squash it. You'd just squash it against the side, against some rock or something. You obviously can't have the risk of it getting on board and savaging people. So yes, you'd have to do something fairly drastic. They have got keepers there with rifles. They're not air rifles either. They are always close at hand, ready to do the worst should the occasion arise. So thankfully, I don't think they've ever had to use those things. I don't think any animals have been shot, and I don't think anybody's been injured or killed there. I don't know for sure. I don't know a lot about Longleat, other than we had a great day when we were there. Yeah, we're fairly close to it here. The tractor was very decent. He actually pulled over to let the traffic go by, which I do appreciate. I do it myself if it's in a road like this, and I've got a much lower speed than cars have. So what I'll do, if there's a convenient lay-by which is not full of potholes and everything, I'll dive in there, and I'll do as a tractor did and just give following traffic a chance to get on their way. It creates less tension and less bad driving if you just are a bit polite and a bit courteous. A little courtesy goes a long way. Well, I've been having a plethora of videos to upload on here lately. Believe me, it's cost me a lot of hours. The upload speed is so low, it's just ridiculous. It's actually worse than when it used to be dial-up, and that was bad enough, my God. But this is even worse, and I don't know why that should be. I check the upload speed, and most times it doesn't even reach a megabyte, which is not good for today's standards, especially when I've got to fork out what they want for the internet. It is quite disgusting, actually, but hey, what can you do? I don't know the names of these little places we are going through, apart from the fact that it's now in Wiltshire, heading towards, I'm pretty sure it's Wiltshire now, heading up towards Longleat, which is in Somerset. The borders are very close. In actual fact, this might be still Somerset. I'm not 100% sure. I know you cross from one to the other. It's like you're in one, then out of it, then back in it, then out of it. It's a really weird border, county border system. So I'm not 100% sure. I believe this could still be Wiltshire, but we're not far from Longleat. Couple of miles, I think. Now you can see by the sky too that the day is clearing up. It's getting really pleasant. As I say, it was very warm there, too warm in fact, but it was a very enjoyable day. There was lots to see, lots of animals and creatures I've never seen in my life before, and I probably never would have done had I not gone there. So yes, it was worth it for that. And my passengers were a good company. I've yeah, this is coming up through the woods. This is very near Longleat, so we're back in Somerset here, obviously. Very near the park. There's lots of little driveways. I think this is the Longleat Estate, or part of it. It's a quite a huge bit of ground that these Longleat royalty kind of people own. Lord Bath or whatever. I remember the original Lord Bath, his son is the one that looks like Epi, is a right weirdo, but it takes all sorts, I suppose. If he's still alive. I don't keep up with items like this. I don't care about royalty or these lords and all these sort of people. They mean nothing to me. They're nothing special at all. They're just overprivileged jerks, most of them. But as for the actual royals, I don't even want to get started on those. Yeah, we're fairly near the entrance to Longleat now. I think I turn out onto, this road. In fact, this could be the, yes, this is. This is the actual entrance to Longleat Estate. I came once as a teenager with my parents many, many years ago. They've got a bit of a boat lake with boats you can have a ride on. And that's what I did. In fact, it was so long ago, I had a, I can't remember the make of it now, but I had a clockwork powered movie camera. It wasn't even a Super 8, it was just an 8mm cine camera with colour stock film in it. I was just getting into photography at that time of my life. And that was the first time I ever came here. This was the second. Many, 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 many years later, and probably the last, but who knows. But anyway, we're very near the end of this video now. As I say, I did take footage of wandering around and seeing the animals and everything, but unfortunately it was not very good video, so it wasn't worth the effort of editing it. It would have been a bit trying to watch it because it was done on a phone and it was very jerky. Not good video. I should have bought a tripod or a selfie stick or something. Yeah, so that's the end of this video, and thanks for watching this one. Hope you've enjoyed it, and hope my commentary wasn't too boring for you. But cheers for watching. I look forward to doing another one.